Some may blame this accidental target fixation, an idea that you will be tempted to go where you are looking. It might be a valid principle, but not in this case. This accident happened because the rider steered in wrong direction.
Counter steering is an amazing technique used by many riders. It's useful in making quick turn and doing some bike stunts like this. At first, counter steering looks natural. You turn the handlebar to left, but the motorcycle makes a quick right turn. What could be the physics behind this phenomena? Let's explore. Before understanding the physics of counter steering, we need to understand the physics behind normal steering and no slip wheel condition.
The rider failed to execute the concept of counter steering.
First, let's explore the means of no slip condition. The wheels are always trying to attain a no slip condition, which means the wheels should have no relative motion with the road. Since the road is at rest, the wheel contact points should have zero velocity. But how zero velocity possible for a moving wheels? It is possible because the wheels has two kinds of motion, a translational motion along with the vehicle and rotational motion of its own axis. You can see that it is possible to make the result of velocity zero at the contact point, since the transitional and rotational velocities are in opposite direction.
Now, in relative of counter steering, if you steer in either direction, you drive the front wheel out under the motorcycle's center of gravity, making it lean in the opposite direction, which means steering left will cause the motorcycle to lean to the right and vice versa.
In normal steering, make a right turn, what we do is just turn the handlebar towards the right and lean the motorcycle inwards. Let's analyze the normal steering operations in a step-by-step manner to understand the physics behind it.
In this accident, since the motorcycle is already banking to the right, turning the handlebar right causes the more wheel to drive back under the center of gravity, causing the bike to stand up and straighten its line, rather than continuing the previous arc.
Assume that even after turning the handlebars, the motorcycle moves straight ahead. Here, if you check the front wheel, it will not meet the no-slip condition, since the wheel and vehicle velocities do not cancel its other out. The only way to solve this problem is by making the translation of velocity inclined as well. This is possible when the whole motorcycle makes a turnaround instantaneous center. The instantaneous center should be at intersection of both the wheel's normal lines. Is it clear that when the motorcycle makes a turn in this manner, both the wheels easily satisfy the no-slip condition? In short, the no-slip condition forces the motorcycle to make a turn.
Watch the video in slow motion and you will see that when the rider sees the fire truck, he sharply turns the bike to the right, that makes the bike to stand up and bear to the left. Surprised, he momentarily releases the steering bar pressure, which makes the bike to follow the original trajectory. And in his panic, he steers right again and again, third times. This why we see that sharp weaving of the bike as it moves directly into the path of the fire truck. Every time he turns the steering bar to the right, this trajectory moves closer into the path of the truck.
Centripetal force needed by any object to make a turn. The centripetal force was provided by frictional force between the tire and the road. Let's do the torque balance on the motorcycle at one point doing the turn. You can see that the vehicle is not stable in this position. The force produced by the frictional force will turn the motorcycle down. The only way to balance this torque is by leaning your motorcycle inward. You can see how the gravitational and normal forces act in an inclined motorcycle position. This will produce another torque, which can counter torque formed by the centripetal force. This is the way we normally turn the vehicle. You turn the handlebar to balance the torque produced by the centripetal force, just lean the motorcycle. Here, the rider has to adjust his body position to achieve the lean of the motorcycle. Note the handlebar turning and the leaning operation happen simultaneously and are in the perfect balance. How is counter steering different from normal steering? In counter steering, you turn the handlebars. However, you do not lean the motorcycle. Obviously, this is the unstable condition. The torque produced by the centripetal force will topple the motorcycle in the opposite direction. In short, the motorcycle achieves the lane in the opposite direction for a moment. This lane is sufficient to achieve a perfect turn in the opposite direction.
Again, and you will see, each time he steers to the right, the bike moves left. That is called counter-steering. If he had steered left, he would have moved to the right, tightened his line, and avoided the collision.
Thing to be noted here is that during the lane operation, the rider cleverly adjusts the angle of the handlebar so that it is suitable for perfect no-slip condition. In short, in normal steering, the lane of motorcycle is achieved by shifting your body weight. In counter steering, the lane is achieved by motorcycle instability caused by the centripetal force. Obviously, counter steering is the quicker operation, but slightly risky. If you don't steer the handlebars back to the proper angle during the leaning operation, you are going to fall down. This is why proper practice is needed to master this instability steering trick. Counter steering is quite handy to avoid sudden obstacle in the road. Let's see how it works in practice.
It's clear in this demonstration that by turning handlebars to the left, the rider was able to shift the motorcycle to the right side. Obviously, the counter-steering is the quicker method to avoid sudden obstacles.
I hope you enjoy this tutorial basics of counter-steering and hoping this will help you to master it and wishing you the best. Please subscribe, like and support my channel. Thanks.